Good morning. Good morning, Chairman, Co-Chairman, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Phatchaya Klongkaew from Maharaj Nakhon Rajasima Hospital. It's my great pleasure to present Evertor muscle function as a predictor of the midterm outcome following treatment of pediatric idiopathic clubfoot. As we know, clubfoot is a compact three-dimensional deformity. The initial treatment is now almost universally agreed to be non-operative, with serial manipulation and casting according to Ponseti method, with or without acrescentotomy, and followed by use of the brace to maintain the correction. Brace compliance was previously found to be significant associated with the recurrence, but some studies show that Evertor muscle function only a factor to predict the recurrence. In 1995, Dr. Felvin performed electrophysiological study in pediatric idiopathic clubfoot. The theory support that muscle imbalance is an etiological factor in idiopathic clubfoot. In 2014, Dr. Jelfer found that only poor Evertor muscle function activity was associated with recurrence in both idiopathic and non-idiopathic clubfoot. After reviewing the literature, we found that there was a few papers about Evertor muscle function associated with idiopathic clubfoot, no method to classify Evertor muscle power, and no paper defined about Evertor muscle training and improvement. The question is, did Evertor muscle function associate with the rate of recurrence in children with idiopathic clubfoot? The study design was retrospective cohort study. After approval from Maharaj Nakhon Rajasima Hospital Ethic Committee, the target population of our study was children with idiopathic clubfoot, initial age before 6 months. Based on previous study, the calculated sample size was 29 children per group, 62 children with idiopathic clubfoot, initial age before 6 months, who were treated at Maharaj Nakhon Rajasima Hospital and followed up at least 2 years, were enrolled in this study. The baseline demographic data and Evertor muscle function were documented at presentation. All children were manipulated and serial plastered serial casting. Evertor muscle function was documented by Cora technique after correction, and all children were trained Evertor muscle and stretching tibialis posterior and Achilles tendon, no Dennis bow by use. Once the children had recurrence, the Evertor muscle function were recorded at the time of presentation. In other no recurrence group, Evertor muscle function were evaluated at 2 years. All the data were documented by single pediatric orthopedist. Evertor muscle function grading by Cora technique divided into 5 scales. In infant, activity was measured as a response to manual stimulation over lateral border of the foot and observed response as feature. Grade 0, no muscle contraction. Grade 1, only seen prominence of tendon under the skin. Grade 2, foot eversion could not reach perpendicular to leg axis. And grade 3, eversion perpendicular to leg axis. And grade 4, perpendicular eversion beyond perpendicular to leg axis. Evertor muscle function grade 3 and grade 4 we group in good Evertor muscle function group. Result, at the time of presentation, we found that all children had poor Evertor muscle function. After serial manipulation and casting, we found 57 children with poor Evertor muscle function and 5 children with good Evertor muscle function. And after training, we found 21 children with poor Evertor muscle function and 41 children with good Evertor muscle function. So we compare the demographic data, including initial age, sex, severity, number of casts, duration in casts, and early tenotomy. The data show that no statistically significant difference between groups. Incidence of recurrence idiopathic clubfoot in good Evertor muscle function group was 7.32%, and incidence in poor Evertor muscle function group was 90.48%. After adjust relative risk, children with poor Evertor muscle function were increased risk of recurrence 9.59 times more than good Evertor muscle function group. Discussion. Our study showed the association between poor Evertor muscle function and the recurrence of idiopathic clubfoot, same as previous study of Dr. Jelfer in 2014 and Dr. Pilajit in 2017. Both studies show that only poor or absent Evertor muscle function was found to be significantly associated with the recurrence. Moreover, our study found that risk of recurrence in children with poor Evertor muscle function was 9.59 times higher than good Evertor muscle function group. And good Evertor muscle function group at least grade 3 after treatment was found to be good protective factor against recurrence in children with idiopathic clubfoot. However, our study found Evertor muscle function could be improved after training, unlike in Dr. Jelfer and Dr. Pijajit's study that report no change in Evertor muscle activity grading at 6 months after complete correction. So we suggest that training of Evertor muscle and foot stretching exercise was an option for children with idiopathic clubfoot to prevent recurrence during treatment. In summary, improvement in muscle balance around the ankle, especially Evertor muscle function, should be emphasized to parents for good outcome after treatment. Thank you for your attention.